Hi friends, welcome back to the brand new series on Angular 0 to Hero, a perfect Angular guide for beginners. In my last video, I have explained about forms in Angular, to be more specific, template-driven forms. And in this video, I am going to explain about model-driven forms or reactive forms in Angular. Reactive forms are forms where we define the structure of the form in the component class. I am going to use the same application which I have used to explain template-driven approach. And also, I'm going to compare every step with the previous approach so that it will be easy for you to understand it better. First, if you see in the template-driven form, we have three fields and then a button of type submit. And then in the form, we have used ng submit event to submit the form. Here in reactive approach also, we have the same three fields and a button to submit. And in ng submit, we are calling the onSubmit function. But the difference is, earlier we passed the reference of the form to the function. Here it is not needed. As we are going to construct the form in the component itself, we can access it directly. Now let's start constructing our reactive form. First, let me create a variable of form group. This can be imported from angular/forms. And in onInit, we can create a form group instance like this, in which we can create the form controls. While creating the form controls, we have option to provide the initial state or the default value and also the validators. Now we have three form fields and so I'm going to create those controls. First argument is the initial state. For username, I want to default it to my name. And the second argument is validators. I will come to that shortly. And for email, I don't want to default it. And so I can either give us null or empty string. And for the third field, checkbox, let me give us false. And so it will not be checked by default. Now we have constructed the form in the component. We need to configure that in the template. In template driven, we have used the ng form directive to bind the form. Here we can use form group directive. When we do this, we get an error. Like how we import forms module for template driven, we need to import reactive forms module for model driven approach. After we import that in app module, we can see the error is gone. But did you notice the default name is not showing? This is because we have just configured the form. We haven't configured the form controls yet. If you remember, in template driven, we have used the ng model directive to bind the controls. Similarly, we can use another directive called form control name to bind the controls here. Let me do that. Now we can see the defaulted value here. Let's see how we can do form validation in reactive forms. Like template driven, we can make use of all form state and other properties. But to add the validation in template driven, we have used the attributes. Here we need to add the validators while creating the form controls. So let me go to the component and add in second parameter validators.required. Validators also we need to import from angular/forms. Now if I inspect the form, we can see the class NGVALID is there. And if I delete the value, we can see it is changed to NGINVALID. So let me copy the CSS from template driven component. Let me also copy the error block. But it will not work because we haven't get access to the controls yet. In template driven, we use the template reference variable and bind it to ng model. But here we can get access to the controls using form.get method. So after I change, it is working. For email field, we need to add two validations. So we can pass an array of validators. Like this. And let me also copy the error blocks and change it accordingly. And let's test this. Okay, it is working. And to disable the button, we can use the same approach like template driven. And also to reset the form, we can call the reset function of the form in the component like we did in template driven. And before we close this topic, let me explain another concept. Let me add a button and call a function. When I click this button, I want to update the values. So for that, I can use setValue function. For setValue function, I need to pass all values. When I add that and click the button, we can see the checkbox is updated. Sometimes when the form is having many fields and we need to update only few fields, we don't want to use set value. Instead, we can use patch value in which we can pass only the intended fields. Now we can see when I click, the checkbox is checked. In the meantime, the other fields are not updated. I believe I have explained the forms in Angular clearly. If you have any doubts, please post it in the comment section, and I request you to replicate the same program with different type of fields like dropdown, text area, radio buttons, etc. I have also uploaded this code in the GitHub repo and provided the link in the description. You can take this code from there. And next I am going to explain about how we can use HTTP module to invoke an API. So if you haven't subscribed to this channel yet, please subscribe, press bell button and stay tuned. Thank you. Bye.